So what we just found is that our empirical distributions have more entropy than even the uniform distribution, provided that the mean is the same, but they have less information than what is perfect, which is the exponential distribution in this case. In fact, we can analytically show that among all distributions with a fixed mean on positive numbers, the exponential is the highest entropy one. And what's the intuition for that? If I take a big interspike interval and I make it a little bigger, I force all other interspike intervals to be smaller. One way of implementing that is that I just say, I take all interspike intervals and I divide it by the mean of that. And if I do those things, there's a trade-off. Now, like, of course I could make entropy larger by having more on the right-hand side, but that forces me to make all others smaller, and therefore I don't get better. So it's this trade-off between forcing the other interspike intervals to be small and allowing high entropy that leads to the exponential being the best solution. And hence, it's better to have the distribution as we saw it there. What have we just learned? In Y models, we start with an idea of what biology should optimize. Say, the information throughput that we could get with the distribution of interspike intervals that we actually have. We then hypothesize constraints. In our case, that the average spike rate is immutable. And then we solve for the best possible solution given the constraints. And the solution here leads us to the exponential distribution. And then we check how well it coincides with our actual measurements. Here, the fact that real neurons seem to roughly have exponential distributions of interspike intervals. So when we have a Y model, we want to understand which behavior would be optimal for the real-world problem in the real world. Now, what have we learned overall in today's tutorial? For all models, we want to describe something that we feel is important, a phenomenon. Here, it was the interspike interval distribution. We draw this, what we find important, in a way from our intuition. In what models? We just want to describe the data with an equation. In how models? We want to describe it in terms of a mechanism. We want to figure out how the brain actually does something. In why models? We want to describe it in terms of an optimal solution to a constraint problem in the real world that the brain actually needs to solve. In a way, why models give meaning to how models. How models give interpretation to how the brain actually does it to what models. Now, there's disagreement in the field. Should we start with why models? Should we start with how models? Or maybe we should start with what models? But it is important for us to be aware of the different model types and the logic that is behind them.